kids love asking stupid questions. The classy endless chain of,
what's it made of?
In all fairness, used to be a really good one. Now, of course, we know the answer is atoms. Indivisible particles that... Oh, right, subatomic particles. The most fundamental of... Oh, come on. The standard model of particle physics is just a fancy name for an idea of classifying the very basic building blocks of everything that exists and how they all interact. It is, nonetheless, a very powerful tool. But we will only focus on the very basics of the central idea in particle physics. This is how the standard model is depicted. It's like a small table that shows every type of fundamental particle. We all know about the proton, the neutron, and the electron. Here's the electron, but you can't find the proton or the neutron anywhere. That's because, unlike the electron, they're made up of smaller things called quarks, or quarks. Quarks are basically particles that make up matter. Oh, and also they have fractional electric charges. But how do you get a fractional electric charge? You don't. They just turned out to have charges smaller than the electron. Instead of changing the whole system of how we measure charge, it was easier to assign new fractional values. Okay, so there are six types of quarks. The up, down, top, bottom, charm, and strange. Why those names? It's not really important. A proton is made up of two up quarks and one down quark, while a neutron has two down and one up. They may have more quarks inside, but those cancel out in particle-antiparticle pairs. Conservation of charge is very important. Since the total charge on a proton is plus one, and the two up quark charges plus one down quark charge add up to one, it balances out. The electron itself is a fundamental particle. It's classified as a lepton, along with its increasingly heavier cousins, the muon and tau leptons, all along with their corresponding neutrino flavors. The latter two are the same as the electron, only heavier and less stable. They decay in very small fractions of a second. Neutrinos are cool, but let's just stick to the fact that they're extremely light and have zero charge. Bosons are force carriers. They're the reason why particles interact with each other. The infamous photons are carriers of light, electromagnetism. The W and Z bosons have something to do with the weak nuclear force, while gluons hold quarks together with the strong force, which counteracts the same charge repulsions. The Higgs boson made news back in 2016 as being the theorized particle that was then found. It provides mass to any particle that interacts with it. Particles like photons are massless because they don't interact with the Higgs boson at all. The force of gravity is still not a part of the standard model. And while a graviton has been theorized, gravity is still too weak at those scales for us to be sure of anything. The standard model is far from perfect. Our inability to unify it with quantum gravity and the recent anomalies found in the muon G-2 experiment make it evident. But it remains one of mankind's biggest stepping stones in understanding the nature of the universe.